So I want to know how to take the derivative of something, a function that looks like this. C raised to the f of x power, where c just represents a number, like 2 or 3, just some constant. So how would I go about taking the derivative of something like this? So a few examples of something of this form might be like 3 raised to the tangent x power. Or maybe 5 raised to the 5x power. Or maybe pi raised to a polynomial, 3x squared plus 7x. Okay, so all of these forms are like this, c raised to some function of x, and I want to know how to take the derivative of this form of function. Okay, so there's really only two things I need to know in order to take this derivative. So first of all, I need to know this rule right here. Okay, so this right here, the derivative of b raised to the x power, once again, b here just represents a number, a constant. This is a more simple form of what I just showed you. Okay, so here I was asking, okay, what about c raised to some function of x? But here I'm just asking, what about just b raised to just x by itself? Well, we know the derivative of this function, b to the x. This is just a simple derivative formula that you learn, and it's the derivative of b to the x equals b to the x times the natural log of b. So this b to the x is an exponential type of function. You'll hear it referred to as an exponential function. Okay, so if we know this, and if we also know the chain rule, so hopefully you remember the chain rule, that's something you have to use all the time when taking the derivative. If we know this rule for exponential derivatives and we know the chain rule, then we can take the derivative of c to the f of x. So let me show you why. Let me show you an example. Okay. So let's start with this one up top here. The derivative with respect to x of 2 raised to the sine x power. So this is 2 raised to some function of x to sine x. Now, if this was just the derivative of 2 to the x, I would say the answer was 2 to the x times the natural log of 2. But here instead, I have 2 raised to the sine x power. But all we have to do is think of this as a composition of functions. You can kind of think of sine as your inner function. You're raising 2 to the sine x power. And whenever we have a composition of functions, we just use a chain rule. So the way that works is you start by taking the derivative of the outer function, just as you normally would. Okay, so I'm going to use the formula for the derivative of an exponential function. So in that form, I keep 2 to the sine x and multiply it by natural log of 2, just like I did over here. But because of the chain rule, I need to multiply by the derivative of my inner function. So I need to multiply by the derivative of sine of x. Okay, so that derivative then, the derivative of sine, is just cosine. Okay, so then my final answer is just the product of all these pieces, and you can arrange them in any order that suits you, but we've basically got 2 to the sine x power times natural log 2 cosine x, and that's our derivative. Okay, let's look at one more example really quickly. So this example's still at that same form, a number, in this case 3, raised to a function, in this case a quadratic polynomial. The only difference here is I have this 5 out front, and I kind of put that there to sort of initially trick you. Some people might be tempted to combine that 5 and that 3 and write this as 15 raised to that same power, but that is incorrect. Since the 3 has an exponent and the 5 does not, we can't combine them through simple multiplication like that. But the 5 doesn't really pose a problem because it's just a constant being multiplied by the piece that we're really interested in taking the derivative of. So if I want, I can just simply pull it out in front of this whole derivative like this. Okay, and then once again, to take this derivative, we're going to combine our knowledge of the derivative of an exponential with our knowledge of the chain rule. Okay, so I start just by taking the derivative of this function as a whole, of the outer function or the outer structure of it. So the derivative of 3 to the x, for example, so I keep the 3 and then I keep this inner function in there. And then remember, times the natural log of 3, that's just part of the derivative of an exponential function. Times, now here's a chain rule, because I'm not taking the derivative of simply 3 to the x, but it's 3 to some function, I need to multiply by the derivative of that inner function. So by the derivative of this quadratic. Okay, and then let's actually take the derivative of that quadratic. Okay, so that's 4x plus 7. All right, and this is kind of messy, but it's the product of 4 different things, and you can, once again, arrange it however you want. So this is 5. Let's see, let's write it as 5. Natural log of 3, 4x plus 7, times 3 to the 2x squared plus 7x plus 3. All right, so this is how you take the derivative of something like c to the f of x. You simply combine the derivative of b to the x of an exponential, and then combine that with the chain rule.